गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर सेपरेशन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस। वी ऑलरेडी नो व्हाट इज अ मिक्सचर। अ मिक्सचर इज मेड अप ऑफ टू और मोर डिफरेंट सब्सटेंसेस व्हिच आर कॉल्ड कंपोनेंट्स। इफ वी कैन सी दीज कंपोनेंट्स देन इट इज कॉल्ड अ हेटरोजीनियस मिक्सचर। इफ वी कैन नॉट सी दीज कंपोनेंट्स देन दे आर कॉल्ड होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर। The question of today is that why do we need to separate the mixtures? So basically, there are three reasons why we need to separate the components from a mixture. So in the morning, when your mummy or father makes a cup of tea, they will add sugar, milk, and tea leaves to water. And then a homogeneous mixture is formed, but we can see the tea leaves inside the tea. So before the tea is consumed, the tea leaves need to be removed. So it is an unwanted component. The second reason is that some of the components are harmful to us. Like if you buy open rice or pulses, there may be some stones or very small pebbles inside it, which are not good for our health. So we need to take it out. Similarly, the third reason is that sometimes in a mixture, we need to separate and get two very useful components. Like when we want to get butter from milk. So we need to churn the milk and then we get butter, and both the parts of the mixture are very useful to us. So that is why we need to separate the different types of mixtures. Now this is a short exercise in which you have to match the columns. So in the first column it is written separation process. In the second column is why do you separate these mixtures, and third column is what do you do with the separated components. So the first mixture is separating stones from rice. So out of these three, you have to choose that why you separate stones from rice. It is the third one, of course, because we want to remove the harmful components. And what do you do with the harmful components? You throw away the component which is not useful or which is harmful to you. Then comes churning milk to obtain butter. So in this mixture, why do we separate the milk and the butter? Because we want to get two different but useful components. And what do we do with these two components? We use both of these components. In the third mixture, separating tea leaves, why do we separate the tea leaves? Because we want to remove the non-useful component. And what do you do with this? You throw the solid component away. So this is a match the column which we will do as classwork. So why is it important to separate mixtures? Since mixtures form part of our everyday life, the separation is very important. For example, purification of drinking water or making filter coffee. So in our day-to-day life, we need to separate some parts or components of a mixture. So when we have to drink water, we just don't drink it directly from the tap because it is not safe for us. So it passes through a procedure in which certain impurities and certain harmful parts of the water are removed. So the mixture is getting separated out. So if you are stuck on a desert island without any drinking water, the knowledge of separating mixtures will in fact save your life, because you will know how to make pure water from sea water. The first way to separate a mixture is hand picking. This is the easiest way to separate a mixture, but there are certain conditions. Let us see more in detail. In hand picking, the components of a solid-solid mixture can be separated. So, both the components of the mixture must be solid. This is only useful when the particles are large enough to be seen clearly. And of course, the mixture is not very large in quantity. So, the conditions for hand picking is that the components need to be solids and the components must be large enough to be seen clearly with the help of your eyes. For example, if we want to separate pebbles from rice, we can see both pebbles and rice. Similarly, separating parts of a salad. So, some mixtures which are solids and large enough to be seen with your eyes can be separated by hand picking. So, as you can see here, if you want to go on the beach and you want to clean it up, because nowadays people make a mess of many things on the beach, so you can easily see the different parts or the impurities or the waste materials which are thrown on the beach, and you can pick it up and clean the surrounding area. So that is how you can use the process of hand picking. But of course, you should always wear protective gear whenever you are trying to separate out such things, because some of them may be not safe to handle. A very easy way or example of hand separation is using a fork to separate out the tomatoes, the lettuce, cucumber, onions from your salad. So when you can see the different parts of the components and that they are large enough, you can separate them by just hand picking. So, components of a solid-solid mixture can be separated by hand picking. This is only useful when the particles are large enough. So, pebbles from rice dal, separating grass from mint leaves, and separating parts of salad. The second way of separation is called threshing. Threshing is a method that is used by farmers to separate the grains from the stalks. As you know that wheat and rice, they are seeds. So these seeds or grains, they grow on stalks. So the dried stalks are beaten, which is also called threshed, to separate the grains. But nowadays, because the amount of grains is very large, so in the large farms, this process is done by large threshing machines. This is the way to thresh the crops. All the harvested crop or the stalks of the crops are binded together and then they are threshed either on a rock or in this case on a drum. Because of threshing, the seeds will separate out from the stalks. So, threshing is a method used by farmers to separate grains from stalk after harvesting. The dried stalks are beaten or threshed to separate the grains. But nowadays in larger farms, this process is done by threshing machines. This is a picture of a threshing machine. As you can see, in one part from one side, the harvested stalks are put inside and the machine will separate out the seeds which will fall on the other side. Winnowing is the third process in which the mixture is allowed to fall from a height. The lighter particles will get separated because of wind from the heavier ones. This method is used to separate the lighter husk, which is the covering of the grains, from the grains like wheat. So, the person can stand at a height and take the grains and then shake it, in which the lighter covering of the grains they blow away by the wind and the heavier seed will settle down. So in winnowing, the mixture is allowed to fall from a height. The lighter components are separated from the heavier components because of wind. This method separates lighter husk from heavier grains. So this is the way in which the winnowing is done. The next process to separate the solid components is sieving. Sieving is used to separate dry mixtures which contain particles of different sizes. That means one of the component must be big enough so that it does not pass through the sieve, and the other component must be small enough so that it can fall through the sieve. So I can separate gravel from sand because gravel is big and cannot pass through the small holes in the sieve, but sand is very small, so it passes through the holes in the sieve. This is a common device that is used in our homes for sieving out juice or soup. So a sieve is a device that contains tiny holes to separate the unwanted elements from the wanted elements. This is how in construction purposes the gravel is separated from the seeds. So sieves can come in different shapes and sizes depending on the materials that need to be separated. So please remember, today we have learned how to separate solid-solid mixtures by hand picking, threshing, winnowing, and sieving.